डिवाइडेड बाय 17 प्लस 17 इंटू 13 माइनस 103 माइनस 85 इंटू 62 प्लस 145 डिवाइडेड बाई 23 इज इक्वल्स टू. सो फर्स्ट वी आर टेकिंग द गिवन एक्सप्रेशन 136 डिवाइडेड बाई 17, दैट इज 136 बाई 17 प्लस 17 इंटू 13 माइनस 103 माइनस 85. 103 माइनस 85 इज इक्वल्स टू 18 इंटू 62 प्लस 145 इज इक्वल्स टू 207 डिवाइडेड बाई 23. डिवाइडेड बाई मीन्स बाई 23. नाउ दिस इज इक्वल्स टू 136 प्लस 17, दिस इज 8 प्लस 17 इंटू 21 माइनस, नाउ हियर 18 इंटू 207 बाई 23. नाउ दिस 23 इज कैंसल्ड बाई 9 टाइम्स. नाउ 18 into 9 is equals to 162. Now this is 221 plus 8. 229 minus 162, which is nothing but 67. That is, answer is the second option. When the following decimals are arranged in ascending order, then what decimal number should be in the middle? Given decimal numbers are 5.74, 6.03, 0.8, 0.658 and 7.2. So, given that these numbers are arranged, when we arrange the given numbers in descending order, then what is the middle term of the given numbers? So, further, first I take the number line here. So, first number is 5.74. 5.74 means that is the number which lies between 5 to 6. So, this is the number 5.74, number lies between 5 to 6. And next number 6.03. 6.03 means that is the number which lies between 6 to 7, that is 6.03. And next number 0.8. 0.8 means this is the number which lies between 0 to 1. So this is 0.8. And 0.658. 0.658 means this is also the number which lies between 0 to 1. 0.658. After 0.658, the number 0.8 comes. 0.6, 0.8. And last number 7.2. 7.2 means that is the number comes after 7. That is, this is 7.2. Now from this number line, we can write the ascending order of the numbers. The first number is 0.658 and the second number is 0.8, next number 5.74, next number 6.03 and last number 7.2. Now what should be the middle number? So here 5.74 is the middle number, which is the second option. Next problem. A tank can be filled by two pipes A and B in 4 hours and 6 hours respectively. When full, the tank can emptied by third pipe C in 8 hours. If all the taps are turned on at the same time, then the tank will be full. So given that a tank can be filled by the pipes A and B in 4 hours and 6 hours, that is, the pipe A fills the tank in 4 hours and the pipe B fills the tank in the 6 hours. Pipe A fills the tank in 4 hours and pipe B fills the tank in 6 hours. That is, A's 1 hour work is equals to 1 by 4. And here B's 1 hour work is equals to 1 by 6. And also given that the tank can be emptied by a third pipe C in 8 hours. That is, C removes the water from the tank in 8 hours. That is, C's 1 hour work is equals to 1 by 8. Now, if all the taps are turned on at the same time, that is, A plus B plus C's 1 hour work is equals to, A plus B plus C's 1 hour work is equal to, pipes A and B fills the tank, but the pipe C removes the water from the tank. That is, we add the two values and subtracting the third value here. That is, 1 by 4 plus 1 by 6 minus 1 by 8. Now taking LCM, here 48 is the LCM. Now 12 times and this is 8 times minus 6 times, 8 6 sir, minus 6, 20 minus 6, that is 14 by 48 and this is equals to 7 by 24. That is, A plus B plus C can complete the work in 24 by 7 hours. Simply we reverse this fraction. Therefore, A plus B plus C can complete the work, then A plus B plus C can fill the tank in 7 hours. That is second option. Next problem. 4 plus 4.44 plus 44.4 plus 4.04 plus 444 minus 20 is equals to. So adding all these numbers and from that result we are subtracting 20 there. So first we are writing the numbers here one by one. First number 4. 4 means 4.0. Next number 4.44. And the next number 44.4. And the next number 4.04. And the next number 444.0. Now adding all these numbers. 8.22.10.15. So addition of all these numbers is equals to 500.88 minus 20. We are subtracting 20 from this number, that is 500.88. 20 means 20.0. Now subtracting the number 88.0. 50 minus 2, 48. 480.88, that is the first option.